most expensive player, Neymar Jr., is yet to kick ball for PSG, officially, that is. That's if his clearance is not sorted out before the end of today, according to sources in France. This is because the French Football Federation has said they are yet to receive the clearance from the Spanish football authorities. And now there are talks about the, you know, FFP and why the delay is even happening in the first place. Well, it's Shengwe is here. I know he's one of those who thought that this 222 million euros move was so outrageous. In another topic, we would talk about, you know, the financial player fair play rules, but let's talk about Neymar, the delay, and then, you know, his impact at PSG.
Well, first things first, as you know, as we're saying off air, I'm caught in between two stools. On the one hand, as you right, use the exact right word, the deal is outrageous. On the second hand, PSG, they wanted a player, and they went for it, and they poked a finger in Barcelona's eye. We shouldn't forget that Barcelona wanted to go for Marco Verratti.
That's right.
And on certain to the extent that Verratti wanted to go.
So it was just payback.
You know, payback big time. And of course, Verratti would not go to Barcelona because it's like he's taking a step down. But we don't know there's some underground machinations going on in Spain, because by now, Neymar's paperwork should have been released. But Neymar has up to 12 midnight today, Friday, if he can go. Because luckily for him or for PSG, the game is on Sunday. If it was Saturday, it wouldn't happen. But since it's on Sunday against Guingamp, then he might be eligible to play. But on the other hand, too, the flip side of the deal is that what you have on Sunday in Spain, you have the first leg of the Spanish Super Cup, which is two of the biggest clubs in the world. That's Real Madrid, reigning European champions, league winners, and Barcelona, cup winners. And who is Neymar? The first game he was supposed to play was against a team called Amiens. Who has ever heard of Amiens?
Who has ever heard of
Amiens? Now we heard Guingamp. You understand? So we are going from playing Real Madrid to here. But hey, but what this deal has done too, because it's a multifaceted, it's turned a light, it's shone a light on the French Ligue 1. People actually want to watch. I remember, you know, they started off last week, and so people are getting in touch with me, when are they showing the French games? Because people want to start watching
the
French
games. They want to start watching it.
And in fairness to Neymar, he's such a personable young boy. You know, when I saw him, his interview, it was like, he hadn't cared. And let's not forget too, apart from the, let's say, almost £200 million that he costs, he's going to be earning a whopping £525,000 a week. I say that again, £525,000 a week. I calculated that in Naira, that he's going to be earning £225,750,000 every week. George, if I was earning that, I wouldn't be sitting here.
Please, let's close this show. Okay. We're in the wrong profession. We're in the wrong profession.
Can you imagine earning $225 million a week, eh? I'm not even sure that would
be enough. Will we still have? We'd have soccer bite, but we could do it anywhere.
Anyway,
we'll
Seychelles today.
Seychelles
Bahamas
today.
Tomorrow.
You know.
Now you're talking.
Do it. You know, on the pitch of Stamford Bridge. Just tell them, Clara.
That's true. Yeah. You know, yeah. With Conte City in the background, it's too.
I mean, crazy
money.
Crazy things happening right now. And like I said, we would, maybe we should just talk about it. Some people have called for a salary and transfer cap right now. And do you think that holds water? I mean, Arsene Wenger has been crying about it for ages.
I tell you what, Arsene Wenger, in fairness, you know, he's been, two things I agree with Arsene Wenger on. One, transfer fees have gone insane.
Very insane.
And in fairness to the player, it has nothing to do with the player. It's all about what people are prepared to pay for their services. That's nothing. I mean, just as insane as Neymar earning 525,000, for instance,
a week.
Is someone like Jesse Lingard earning £110,000 a week in Old Trafford. I mean, his agent must be a rocket scientist. You know, so it's basically, you know, it's what the person that wants to employ is willing to pay. You know, but it's gone crazy because even average player, look at Kyle Walker, £50 million. So when Monaco was selling, I think they were looking at 35, 40. They said, you know what, above 50, you know, you have to equal what you paid for Walker. And also, the transfer market has gone crazy.
And that's what's happening in Coutinho now. Liverpool, of course, know that Barcelona have a lot of money.
In fact, so breaking news from a source says like say May, I emphasize what may have put in a transfer
request.
Because it's blown transfers out of the water. Lukaku, £75 million. In fact, United
Lukaku.
£25 million, you know. £75 million, you know, and even Matic, Mourinho bought Matic from Benfica 2-3 years ago, when 2014, probably for £21 million.
Now
Chelsea sold him to United for £40 million.
That's good business.
That's fantastic business. Good business for Chelsea.
Well, back to Neymar. La Liga, the La Liga authorities believe that PSG are violating UEFA's financial play rules.
Almost definitely. Rules,
and they will report the French club to UEFA for an FFP breach. Where were they when all this was happening in the first place? When the deal was struck, when Neymar took his bags and went to France.
Well,
FIFA have said they've not heard anything. They've not heard.
Well, even if they do report, it's not whatever sanctions will be put in place, because we have to remember PSG and Manchester City have been hit with sanctions. Well, I think City was fined about £60 million.
Yeah.
And had a squad reduction from 25 to 21 players. I think 2-3 years ago in the Champions League as well. So even if it's going to hit Paris Saint-Germain, Paris PSG, it's going to come much later. And then if you look at the financials of the deal as well, they'll probably start making their money back.
From shirt sales.
From shirt sales. Already they're selling shirts at 100, 150 euro per Neymar shirt. And
Neymar shirt.
As I said, the pure commercial frenzy.
It's what happened with Pogba as well.
Exactly. Exactly. And Zlatan as well, who came on the free, but was earning big money. So there's method in their madness, really. But I think Arsene Wenger's biggest grouse, and I think that's where PSG, because they have, no matter what they say, they have rubbished financial fair play rules, is that Neymar was bought by Qatar, the country of, not by PSG. They were bought. Nobody has any evidence to that, but Qatar is owned by QSI, the Qatar Sports Institute, which is an organ.
That's PSG is owned by QSI.
And QSI is an organ
Of
the Qatari government. So as far as I'm concerned, Qatar, the country, bought Neymar for PSG. So at the end of this,
Qatar be the ones to be sanctioned?
No, they can't. No. Obviously, there's no paper trail, because the whole deal now is that Neymar is supposed to have been made an ambassador to Qatar 2022, and for that he was paid £500 million pound or euro, something like that, out of which he has paid. So you guys, Neymar is the one that paid Barcelona the money. Wasn't
that paid
PSG?
Them, yeah.
Yes, I paid Barcelona the money. So that's how they feel.
And,
but
and
we all
his
know.
Body language before he left showed that he really wanted to go. Well, that means the romance with Qatar and then maybe Qatar Airways goes on from Barcelona to PSG then. Ordinarily, as a Barcelona player, he was an ambassador to the Qatar.
Yeah, Qatari. So maybe that's how Qatar the contacts were initially. But then, maybe Neymar too, because I've told how Brazilian players revere winning the whatchamacallit now, the Ballon d'Or. They're really, right. And truth of the matter, if he plays with the likes of Messi, Suarez, he's not going to be standout. Will be the standout player in PSG. So he might have had many reasons, but the money, the financials of that deal are mind-bogglingly watering. But as I said, footballing-wise, he's playing in much lesser league. And as I said, they were supposed to be AMIA last week, they won 2-0. They're playing Gigon away, compared to playing Barcelona.
Okay, just before we get back to the Ligue 1 fixtures, Ligue 1, of course, already commenced last weekend. Let's look at the list of the top 10 transfers of all time. Neymar, of course, is number one. With his £200 million move from Barcelona to PSG. Paul Pogba is still at number two, from Juve to United for £89 million. Number three is still Gareth Bale from Tottenham to Real Madrid, £85.3 million. And we have Cristiano Ronaldo, of course, from Manchester United to Real Madrid for £83.7 million. The fifth highest transfer is that of Gonzalo Higuain, when he made it from Napoli to Juve for €75.3 million. Romelu Lukaku comes in at number six Who would have thought Romelu Lukaku would be one of the most expensive players in the world?
I mean, if Higuain, who is 28, 29,
yeah,
could go for £75 million, although in fairness, he's played at a higher level.
Higher level, yeah.
But he scored quite a few goals for Juve last season. He lived up to some. Lukaku at 24, I think that's a fair point.
Okay. Everton to United at £75.3 million. Luis Suarez is at number 7 with that move from Liverpool to Barcelona.
That was a steal.
That was a steal
by Barcelona. I mean, in hindsight now, that was a steal.
Yeah, just before the World Cup.
Yeah, that was a steal because he hit the ground running and he delivered big time. MSN, as we all know.
Big time. And of course, Neymar's £71.5 million move from Santos to Barcelona actually stands it at number 7 because he's always breaking.
That was a steal. You bought him at £75 million, sold him at almost 200. And there's a story for West Ham. Apparently, West Ham were looking at Neymar in 2010 when he was in Santos, but they couldn't agree on the price. I think West Ham was offering £29 million.
Yeah.
You know, but you know how it is. There's always buying Brazilian players. Third party ownership.
There's always a clause.
Even that deal between Barcelona and Santos is still not really.
All right. So Neymar's always he's always had this money. I wonder what he's gonna do with all this money that he makes now.
Yeah.
James Rodriguez move to Real Madrid costs £71 million, and Alvaro Morata's move from Real Madrid to Chelsea is £70.9 million.
James Rodriguez, that guy, very unfortunate, was one of the best players in 2014
World Cup.
But now that he's barely played at Real Madrid, now he's gone to Bayern Munich. He's got injured. So sad.
So sad indeed.
I think it's lightweight.
All right. That said, let's quickly run down the fixtures for the French Ligue 1 this weekend. Nice take on Troyes. Rennes versus Lyon. Nantes versus Marseille. Amiens versus Angers. Bordeaux versus Metz, Caen versus Saint-Étienne, Toulouse versus Montpellier, Strasbourg up against Lille, and we're hearing some unfortunate story right there that Vincent Ayama is injured and he's fallen down the pecking order. Lille have acquired its services of two new goalkeepers.
He was invited to training late. He's been injured. I think he needs to look for a new club.
New club, indeed.
It's been a very good time.
Dion take on Monaco and Guingamp are up against PSG. PSG, of course, Lyon, Lille, Marseille, Guingamp, PSG, and Monaco and Saint-Etienne all share 3 points from the opening day. And there's no reason PSG shouldn't win the league this season.
No, there's a phrase I like using. Just as I said, Pep, with all the money he spent, he's condemned to winning something. If Pep goes through next season, not winning any, I'm sure they will sack him.
If no matter PSG what they does not win, the
and
league.
If PSG with spending this kind of money, especially Bayern, but they're not only
it's even the league. They're
condemned to win a treble. They're condemned to win everything with that kind of money, because they're going to look stupid if they don't. You know, that's the risk when you go out there and buy, and that's why I love a team like Spurs. Spurs are the only team in the Premier League that have not bought any player. But if you look at Spurs back to front, their spine, any way you look at it. If they're buying,
they're good at that.
If they want to sell, Harry Kane at least $100 million. If they want to sell, Dele Alli
with Neymar now $220 million.
Exactly. If I'm more, they bought. I start with correct. I think Dele Alli cost £5 million.
Yeah, he came for cheap. All right. So let's see how that goes. If PSG will look stupid at the end of the season, but it's just kicked off and. We hope that the issue with Neymar is also sorted out in time to see him kick ball competitively for the first time for PSG. The Ligue 1 is upon us as well.